In this video, I'm going to show you how to install a new electrical outlet. I wanted a new electrical outlet installed in our master closet. So the first thing I had to do was figure out which electrical circuit I was going to tap into. The easiest option was to use the circuit that feeds these switches on the other side of the wall. The most important step is turning off the right breaker. If you don't know which breaker it is, just turn them all off. I'd rather not be electrocuted, so I'm still going to use my voltage detector even though I've turned the breaker off. I'm going to remove these switches so I can get a better look at how this box is wired. I'm also going to take my shop vac and just clean up a little bit. So here I'm trying to identify which wire is my hot wire. Typically it's going to be a black wire that's connected to the hot terminals of the switches or the plugs that you're looking at. In this case, the hot wire is coming in on the far right, and this hot wire feeds all three of these switches. You can also easily see the neutral wires together and the ground wires that are all twisted together as well. So the switch box is going to be nailed to a stud. I'm going to use my stud finder to tell me which side the stud is on. The location of the stud will determine where I cut my opening in the drywall in the closet for my new outlet box. This is the single gang box I'm going to use. It's made for old construction, which means it's not going to be nailed to a stud. It has those little tabs on it that when you screw it in, the tabs flip up, and actually that's what holds it in because the tabs catch the drywall. Here I'm measuring the height of my outlet box. Typically, the bottom of the outlet box will be about 12 inches above the finished floor. I'm going to locate my stud again so I know exactly where to cut the hole for my new outlet box. I'm just going to use the outlet box and trace around it so I know exactly where to cut. I'm using what's called a jab saw to cut the hole out. The easiest option is just to use a multi-tool, but I wanted to show the cheapest way to do it. So I was going to be a fancy boy and show you how to use fish tape to pull the wire through the wall. But I couldn't pull the fish tape and the wire back through the box, and it was just a total fail. So instead, I'm going to show you the easier and cheaper way to do it. So it's really important to use the correct gauge wire. The circuits run using 14-2 gauge wire, so that's what I'm going to use. So here I'm using a flathead screwdriver to pry up one of the trap doors in the back of the box. I'm going to feed about 4 feet of wire into the wall. That way I know there's enough in the wall that I can fish it out with my hand using the hole I cut out for the electrical box. So I pulled the wire through the opening, and now I'm going to thread it through one of the trap doors in the outlet box I'm going to use. Now that I've got my outlet box installed, I'm going to tighten these screws, and when I do that, it's going to flip up those tabs and it's going to pull it tight to the drywall. So here I'm getting ready to strip my wires. I start by cutting the plastic sheathing off with a utility knife. And you have to be really careful when you're doing this not to nick any of the insulation around the wires that are inside of it. I've also left about 10 inches of this cable coming out of this box. That should give me plenty to work with. I usually end up removing about 6 inches worth of this plastic sheathing though. So once I cut it open, I'm going to fold the plastic sheathing and craft paper back. I'll clip all this off just using a pair of wire snippers. Here I'm using my wire strippers and I'm going to remove about 1/2 inch of insulation off of each of these wires. Here I'm combining the neutral wires, so I'm going to take the wire nut off the old ones, I'm going to take my new one and line it up with the old ones and twist it in. Now I'm working on my ground wire. I'm going to take a piece of copper wire and use it as a splice. I'm going to bend it and connect it to the switch, and I'm going to splice all of the ground wires together. So I'm just using a pair of pliers to try to twist these wires together. I'm trying to get a really nice tight twist. I'm going to use my wire strippers to actually cut a nice end off, and then I'm going to go back and add a few more twists, and that's going to tighten it up nicely. And finally, I'm going to use a wire nut to cap it off. And here I'm working on twisting my hot wires together. Once I've got them twisted, I'll put a wire nut on it. Now I'm ready to install the plug in the closet. So I've already prepared my wires the same way as I showed you earlier. I'm connecting the hot wire, it's being wrapped around that screw in a clockwise fashion, and I'm going to tighten it down with my screwdriver. I'll then connect the neutral and the ground wire using the same method. Now that the outlet's wired up, I'm going to fold the wires back, and I'm going to screw the outlet into the box. Now I'm putting the faceplate on and I'm done. I'm going to test my outlet and I'm going to put the cover back on the switch box, and that'll be it. I'll turn the breaker back on. So if you thought this video was helpful, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thanks.